We have many contenders in the IT networking environment. Some of the networking vendors that are making it out there, to mention but a few, we have Cisco, Juniper, Ubiquiti, Microtik, and many more. In our series, we'll be focusing on Microtik. Welcome to Technology for All Academy Microtik series. My name is Thabang Makobe, the founder of Technology for All Academy. In my hand here, I'm having a Microtik Rotabot. We're gonna open it or unbox it to see what's inside. We have the manual, we have the router, and there's also the power connect. As you can see, port 1 is for internet or to connect to WAN. When you configure a Microtik router, you cannot connect to port 1 because port 1 has firewall rules applied on it. Microtik router comes pre-configured, meaning you can just buy it and plug it to your modem or your ISP router and it will be working and giving supplying internet to your network. Microtik router by default, it's using IP address 192.168.88.1. So in our lesson today, we'll be learning how to access the Microtik router, the ways in which you can connect to your Microtik router in order to configure it. Without any waste of time, we're gonna connect our Microtik router to our PC so that we can see ways to access the Microtik router. We can connect the Ethernet cable from ETH2 up to ETH4. As I've said, we cannot use ETH1. I've already connected to our router. Now I would like to show you the IP address of my computer. To do that, on the search box, we type CMD for command prompt. We open our command prompt and give the command ipconfig/all. As you can see, default gateway is 192.168.88.1. That's our Microtik IP address. And we got 192.168.88.254. That's the address that we got from our DHCP server. Let me close this. So we have three ways in which we can connect to our Microtik router. I'm going to show all three ways that we can use, starting with the URL. What you do, you open your web browser, you open your search engine. I'm using Google Chrome, so I'm opening Google Chrome, and in my URL, I'm typing 192.168.88.1, enter. I'm inside my Microtik router. This is what we call a webfig. Webfig is similar to Winbox. And then we have Quickset. On the Quickset, as I've said, Microtik routers come pre-configured. As you can see, by default, it's home access point. But if I click the drop-down arrow, you can see there's basic access point, cap, CPE, home AP, home mesh, point-to-point bridge access point, point-to-point bridge, customer premises equipment, WISP AP. So by default, it comes as home access point. And you can see that on the WAN, the default is automatic, meaning it's on DHCP server. The mode is for DHCP server. If we connect our modem into our Microtik router, we're gonna get internet or IP address from the ISP automatically. And that's our LAN information. So what you need to do here is to choose your country. For example, I'm in South Africa. I'll choose South Africa because every country has its own standards when coming to frequency ranges. So that's why we have to choose our country. Last but not least, we have terminal or command line interface. So when using URL, you can connect to your Microtik router with IP address only. The second method that we'll be using is using the Winbox. In order to get the Winbox, we have to go to MikroTik website to download the Winbox. To do that, we type MikroTik download and then we double click on MikroTik and wireless so that it can take us to MikroTik website. And then under software, you can see there's Winbox, Dut, NetShell, Flashing, Bandwidth Test. You click the drop down arrow in order to download the Winbox that's compatible with your PC. If your PC is 64-bit, you'll download the 64-bit version. If it's 32-bit, you'll download the 32-bit version. I've already downloaded my Winbox. So to open it, let me go to Downloads. In Downloads, there's my Winbox. I've already double-clicked it because I've already downloaded it. And in Winbox, you can either use the IP address or the MAC address to connect to your router. So in this case, I'm gonna use the MAC address to connect to my router. Connecto, that's the MAC address of my MikroTik router. So I'm gonna say connect. And as you can see, I'm inside the Winbox. The Winbox is a graphical user interface. So this is a list of the things that you can do inside the Winbox. For now, we're not gonna do anything. Just wanted to show you where to get the Winbox and what the Winbox looks like. More in lessons to come. And last but not least, we have what we call terminal monitor or command line interface. For command line interface, we're gonna be using a terminal emulator that's called PuTTY. In order to get PuTTY, you can go to your URL again. Let me open a new URL and then you can type PuTTY download so that it can take you to a website that you can download PuTTY. So let's type it, PuTTY download, enter, download PuTTY free latest version. Can double click it and then it will take you to the site where you can download PuTTY for your PC. That says free download for PC. So in our case, I've already installed my PuTTY. I'll open my PuTTY and there when it says hostname or IP address, I'm gonna type IP address of my MikroTik router, which is 192.168.88.1. And I'm using Telnet. Let me use Telnet to connect to it. Open, wants me to log in and the login is admin. Enter, password, it's empty. There's no password on MikroTik router by default. So also on the terminal emulator or on our PuTTY, I'm not gonna do anything. I just wanted to show you how to get PuTTY and how to log into your command line interface for the first time. Hope this was informative and hope you really gained a lot from this session or lesson. If you like this lesson, please don't forget to subscribe and also leave comments in order to motivate or give us few pointers where we went wrong and where we can improve. Your input will be highly appreciated. I hope this was informative and have a great day. Thank you a lot.